Actually thank Sir Dr. Steve Bass and tell him how extremely happy I am to have worked on this project with you. This man, seriously, he is unbelievable. So amazing. Look at this! Okay, we don't have a lot of time! He's great. Over some speeches and all that jazz, and I'm just gonna sing. But how lucky are we that we have a safe place in this world to come? Theater and music is just so special, and I'm so grateful to be a part of this community that's built on acceptance and where being different is special and important. And I'm so happy that I get to share that with all of you tonight. So I'm gonna breathe, I'm gonna take my shoes off. Fun. While it lasted. And we're gonna sing. Ready, doctor? Look at me. I'm as helpless. Tree. much in love. Can't you see that you're leading me on? And it's just what I want you to do. Don't you notice how hopelessly I'm lost? That's why I'm following you. What's the perfect balance between yelling too much or not yelling enough so that people don't walk over you? Is it a crime just to want to be nice, to avoid confrontation and show everyone a little respect? Time after time, I find that I'm struggling to tell you what's burning inside, a glimmer of hope that you'll finally see. Yet I remain quiet. Look at my face, don't you dare turn away, 'cause I'm losing my patience. Show me now you're the man that I wanna be with for the rest of my life. I have so much love to give you, just open up your eyes and you'll see. Time after time, I find that I'm struggling to tell you what's burning inside, a glimmer of hope that you'll finally see.
Sing something fun now. Hope I remember the words. Hey.
the shit you've done, you can't outrun the way you undersold me. You acting like you bought me at a bargain sale, you don't even care. You focus your frustration on a small detail, you blow it.
Woo!
Have I actually understood this weird quirk I've tried to suppress or hide? Is a talent that could help me meet the wizard if I make good. So I'll make good. When I meet the wizard, once I prove my worth. Wizard wisdom by my looks, he won't be blinded. Do you think the wizard is dumb or like Munchkin, so small-minded? No, he'll say to me, I see who you truly are, a girl on whom I can rely. Oh, that's how we'll begin, the wizard and I. When I meet the wizard, my whole life will change. 'Cause when you're with the wizard, no one thinks you're strange. No father is not proud of you, no sister acts ashamed, and all of Oz has to love you, and by the wizard you're acclaimed. And this gift or this curse I have inside, maybe it'll last, I'll know. Sit in on your verdigris. Would it be alright by you if I degreenify you? And of course that's not important to me.
Alright, why not?
I'll reply. Oh, when we're hand in hand, the wizard and I. Yes, what a pair we'll be, the wizard and I. Sip your tea. haunt my dreams. No, no, they can't take that away from me. They may never, never meet again on the bumpy road to love, but I'll always, always keep the memory of the way you hold your knife, the way we danced till three, the way you changed my life. No, no, they can't take that away from me. No, they can't take that away from me. The way you wear your hat, the way you sip your tea, the memory of all that. No, no, they can't take that away from me. The way your smile just beams, the way you sing off key, the way you haunt my dreams. No, no, they can't take that away from me. We may never, never meet again.
We met, of all places, in front of Gristiti's, some freakishly cold winter's day. I had on several unflattering layers of wool. He slipped on the ice with his grocery bags full. So I rescued some Fruit Loops he dropped by the curb, and he made some remark that my smile was superb. And I thought that was sweet, and I started to go, and he said, "Hey, what you doing tomorrow? Because I'll be here on the corner of Bleecker and Mercer tomorrow at 7. If you want to meet up, I'll be waiting right here. And in case there are two fellas waiting for you, my name's John." He waved and then he was gone. Needless to say, I went back there to meet him, mostly to see if he'd show. And there he was out in the cold with his jacket pulled tight. He took me to dinner and kissed me goodnight. The next week we went to this terrible play, and the week after that drank hot chocolate all day. When suddenly 8 or 9 months had flown by, when he said, "Hey, what you doing the rest of your life? Because I'll be here right beside you as long as you want me to be. There's no question. There is nothing I've wanted so much in my life. This might sound immature, but I'm totally sure you're the one." And we had just been launched in September, our favorite month, with a rock band that played in this old synagogue. And we got an apartment on West 17th Street and talked about children and getting a dog. Our first anniversary came in a flash, and we promised to take the day off. To stop into his office that morning, and so I went walking uptown to this bakery I know, when I heard on the street what I thought was a joke, till I heard all the sirens and saw all the smoke. So I'm running back home with this feeling of dread to the voicemail he left and the last words he said. I'm sorry. I don't mean to ruin your evening by bringing up all of this stuff. You're probably wondering why I even called you tonight. Well, today something happened that spooked me, all right. I saw this storm cloud of papers fall down from the sky, and I thought of that day, and I started to cry. When as sure as I breathe, I heard John clear as day saying, hey, you're allowed to move on. It's okay, because I'll be here. Even if you decide to get rid of my favorite sweater, even if you go out on my birthday this year instead of sitting at home, letting all of life's moments pass by, don't have to cry, because I'll be here when you start going back to the places we went to together. When you take off my ring and you let yourself smile. When you meet someone handsome and patient and true. When he says that he wants to be married to you. When you call him one night and you meet him downtown and you finally answer him. It has taken so long, but I'm ready to start. Right now, John's whispering congrats in my ear, 'cause I finally let myself tell you that I will be
doozy. I'm gonna do something funny now.
My love affair with you is over. It's through. We loved and then we lost, and while it came at quite the cost, we both had the chance to grow. I've collected my thoughts, and once before I go, there's just one thing I want you to know. I want to punch you in the face.
Rip out all your hair. I want to burn you alive, and if you survive, I'll strap you to an electric chair. Or lean out a window a little too far. Don't look both ways and get hit by a car. Fall out of a roller coaster. Take a warm bath with a plugged-in toaster. In short, I hope you die. Maybe it's wrong to wish death on someone you had so much love for, but since we shared so much, it makes me want to kill you more. I hope you both are doing great. New couples always are. I hope this won't make you mad. I did something bad. I played a little joke which involves her car. I took out my knife and I slashed every tire, smashed in the windshield and set it on fire. Then I left a little note which said, leave town or I'll cut your throat, bitch. In short, maybe I think these things to cope with sleeping alone each night. But obviously I'm still thinking of you, wishing that we could just start over new. Why don't we just give us one more try? Sucks that we can't, cause you're a prick who deserves to die. Dysentery, die, gonorrhea, die, lupus, die, get beaten and slugged, molested and mugged, wake up to find you were date raped and drugged, I hate you, I'm leaving, goodbye, in short, I'm over you, so die! Sorry to my holy grandparents about that one. Sorry. Moving right along.
Across the meadows of my heart.
next piece is pretty special to me and also to my family because my uncle wrote it. My uncle, his name is Christopher Curtis, and he wrote a musical called Chaplin, which was actually on Broadway in 2012, which is so cool. I got to go to the premiere, and the Jonas Brothers were there, so that was cool. But anyway, so this piece is really, really cool. It's very dynamic, and it's got a lot to offer, and I've used it as my audition piece for years. And yeah, so I just wanted to tell you my uncle wrote it. Sing. Hey there, Mr. Chaplin. You may think I'm rather small, 'cause the posh papers are falling at your feet. So go ahead and snub me, and don't return my calls, and build your house on top of Easy Street. But what you gonna do when it all falls down, 'cause I let a little rumor spread? What you gonna do if I change the name of the person sleeping in your bed? What you gonna do when I tell the tale that makes the country turn its head? With just a little gossip and just a little lie, I'll simply say the little tramp is just a little spy. And what you gonna do when it deserves applause? You wave our flag and the country is impressed. But I'm the voice among the crowd that's questioning your cause, and now I'll spread my doubts among the rest. And what you gonna do when it all falls down, and where you gonna go from there? What you gonna do when the money's gone, and who you gonna buy to care? What you gonna do when the country says, now get yourself out of here? And what you gonna paint when you cannot paint the town? I'm gonna wipe the smile from that famous little clown. And what you gonna do when it all falls down? And all the king's horses and all the king's men will never put poor Charlie together again. And what you gonna do when it all falls down?
Thank you.
Take a quick little 5 minutes. I was sure I'd have to pee by now, but I don't. That's so weird. Steve said that. All right, we're gonna keep going. Okay, so this next little thing, my dad and I, we made really quickly, just a really quick little description. My dad and I made last summer a Lullabies of Broadway album. And so, go ahead, Mom, you just take your time. And so we're gonna do a little medley of that. So here's my dad, Paul Kelly, he's amazing. All right, let's go.
That fills forever, all the love I have, I give to you. On time's journey to infinity, our hearts will be bound together. Count the seconds, true. Someday I'll wish upon a star and wake up where the clouds are far behind me, where troubles melt like lemon drops, way above the chimney tops. That's where you'll find me, somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly, bird fly over.
It's you, you're the one. arranged that one. This one is for Elise and Shauna. I should have known when I met you by the Orthodox synagogue. I should have known when I saw you buying extra locks at the bagel shop. I should have known you're not to blame. I should have seen we're not the same. It doesn't take an Einstein. You've got the nose, you've got the name. The name is Steinstein. I'm not sure what you want me to do, but I think this is worth working through. I'll admit it's a little bit out of the blue, but I might as well try. I think I could be Jewish for you. Like, on the holidays, I'll stop baking gingerbread, start making challah. When Hanukkah comes, heck, I'll light the mandala. Menorah, excuse me, if you could just choose me, I'll sing idle, idle, not falla. Yeah, as far as the culture, I might need a clue, but I'll give it a shot, cause I've got to be Jewish for you. I'll go with you to temple, I'll try to learn Yiddish, I'll start eating kosher, I'll even play Quidditch. Nope, that's not a Jew thing. Well, teach me some new things, I won't be the slightest bit skittish. I'll do it by rote till it feels like it's true. Yeah, till I'm beclamped, I'll attempt to be Jewish for you. I could be Irish or Russian or French, though Chinese is a bit of a stretch. Just wait, even your rabbi will call me a mensch. Did I mention I've been practicing Mikovich? Oh, I will adapt to where the average girl freezes. But if I have to have the just friends talk, I'll have it with Jesus. Sorry, Jesus. You're just not my type. Whatever they are, I could learn to like latkes. And if we have sons, then they'll all have bar mitzvahs. Bar mitzvahs, I'm joking. I promise I know things enough not to ruin Shabbat. Cause if that's what it takes, then that's what I'll do. Just don't run away, and one day I'll be Jewish for you. Tell me you've never questioned one holy command. Tell me, don't you think love's more romantic unplanned? Just tell me you're nervous, we'll start with a service. Just tell me where you stand. Tell me I need you, tell me in Hebrew. Teach me L'chaim and Horcrux and Oy. Just let me try. Instead of hi, I'll say shalom. Till my hovel feels like home. But I won't say goodbye. So here's what I propose. I'll read through the Torah from cover to cover. Till even Moses could see we were meant for each other. You know I adore you, so let me fight for you. Together we'll take on your mother. Yeah, it might be a prayer, but a prayer can come true. I dare you to dare me, I swear I'll come through. And I'm with you, there isn't a thing I can't do. So if you're inclined, I won't mind being Jewish. For my mama, because she used to sing it like this, and I copied everything she did.
Oh.
without him just ain't no home to me. Can't help loving that man of his pair of wings worn and rusted from too many years by my side. They can carry me, swear to be sturdy and strong, but see turning them on still means goodbye. And so here we go, Bluebird, off to the sky on your own.
was basically it. I can't express how grateful I am that you guys all came out to support tonight. I have no words. It's just, I'm
amazing.
Thank you again to Steve, my partner in crime.
How about this guy?
Yes, Steve, go Steve. And then thank you to the Lillypad for hosting us in this super cool venue. All right, so this is our last song. This Will Be by Natalie Cole. What? Steven, we made it. All right, well, mingle.